Any superstitions going into the game? Any special thing you carried into the game on Sunday that you had tucked away somewhere?
I did. I always, you know, I've learned a lot from my wife over the years. She's so about the power of intention, you know, and believing things that are really going to happen. And she always makes a little altar for me at the game because she just wills it so much. And so she put together a little altar for me that I could bring with pictures of my kids. And I have these little special stones and healing stones and protection stones. And she has me wear a necklace and take these drops she makes. And I say all these mantras. And I stopped questioning her a long time ago. I did. I just shut up and listened. And at first I was like, this is kind of crazy. And then about 4 years ago, we were playing the Seahawks. And she said, you better listen to me. This is your year, but this is all the things you're going to have to do to win. And I did all those things. And by God, you know, it worked. It was pretty good. And then in 2015, it was about early January. And she said, you know how much I love you. And I said, yeah. And she said, I just want to let you know this is not going to be your year.
Oh.
And of course, we lost. I said, what does 16 look like? And she said, 16 is going to be your year. So it was early January this year. And I said, babe, I asking, like, do we have a chance? And she said, yeah, but you're going to have to do a lot of work and you're really going to have to listen to me. So, man, I listened to her. And right after the game, she said, see, I did a lot of work. You do your work, I do mine. She said, you're lucky you married a witch. I'm just a good witch.